Good evening and welcome to For Further Review. It's my pleasure today to present to you Leslie Etherly, who is with their Extended School Program, and also Trent Klingensmith, who is with Junior Achievement. And we have just started a partnership with Junior Achievement this summer. And so, Leslie, would you please talk about how that partnership happened, please? How did you find Trent, and how did we go about implementing this in our schools?
I've been working with the Junior Achievement Program for several years, and I have seen what it can do for the community. And when I came on to the Murfreesboro City Schools, that was one of my goals, was to be able to get that program into our summer program for the extended school part of Murfreesboro City Schools. And so I set up meetings with the Junior Achievement group. We went down for a tour of their facility in Nashville for BizTown, and just came up with the idea that we would get this into 11 of our schools during the summer program.
And could you talk a little bit about what that has meant for the students?
Students have loved it. The programs are so easy and so engaging, and just for these kids to be able to experience what goes on in our community and how our communities really work as far as business has just been a great experience for them this summer.
How many days a week? How many hours?
We did the program a little bit different. Usually the programs run about 5 weeks. It's 1 hour a week in the schools. We went ahead and completed the program in 1 week, so we had an hour a day for 1 week at each school.
Do you foresee expanding this in the fall and in the spring?
I would love to expand this in the fall and spring. I know that we've got a lot of our extended school students will be there when the school starts. We'll still have some of the same students, but we'll have new ones to come in. I'd like to also get this into our classrooms.
Okay. All right. Thank you so much for initiating this for us.
Sure.
Trent, it's a real pleasure to have you.
It's great to be here, Doctor.
Could you talk about what you do at Junior Achievement, please?
Well, Leslie did a great job of doing that. Our goal is to try to connect the community with the classroom. And we do it through business education for the most part. It's about teaching kids about free enterprise and entrepreneurship. But it's really about the partnership. It's about the community, the education side, and then the volunteer, and finding ways that we can get the volunteer in the classroom to help the kids understand the relevance of that education that they're getting every day. It's about that opportunity to make sure the kids know that they can truly be whatever they want to be when they grow up.
One term that I hear mentioned a lot is BizTown. Could you talk a little bit about BizTown and what that is, please?
Well, I appreciate you bringing that up. It's one of my favorite subjects. BizTown is a small city that we have that literally has 14 different working shops. Teachers come to JA and they get the curriculum, they take it back to the classroom, teach the curriculum to the kids for about 6 weeks, and the curriculum fits into what the teachers are required to teach every day, so it molds in perfectly. And then they have the opportunity to come into BizTown for the day and they have a job. They've interviewed for this job, they filled out job applications, they get paid during the day. So it's a real working city with a real working economy where they get the opportunity to take out loans to start a business and pay off the loans at the end of the day. So great experience for them.
Sounds like something that our Congress could learn from at this
point. We'll get that about Congress, spouses, those type of things.
So it's really a working city. I mean, you have, what kind of stores do you have there? When I think of working city, I think of pharmacy, I think of grocery store, I think of loggers, so could you talk a little bit about, kind of paint the picture for us about what that is?
We have, let's go around the block if you don't mind for a second. We've got a restaurant. We've got a radio station, so we have kids that work as DJs. We have a bank. Probably the toughest job in the city is being the banker for the day, because they're the ones who have to approve the loans and then make sure that they're all paid off at the end of the day. We have a pet store. Mars Pet Care has sponsored that store. We have a Dollar General store. We have a print shop called Nova Copy. We have a little hospital where the kids can actually take out health insurance during the day, a newspaper, delivery center. So all in all, 14 different shops, all with a CFO and a CEO in each shop, and then the pertinent jobs that go with what's required for that job. So,
could you talk a little bit about, I know that one of the things that I asked you before this was, is Junior Achievement one program, or do you have more than one program? So could you give us kind of the expanse of what Junior Achievement really is?
Well, it is actually made up of several different programs. We have the BizTown program that we just talked about, where the kids actually come to us. And they experience that opportunity to take what's being taught in the classroom and live it out. Then we have a program where we actually have volunteers go into the classroom, which is a lot of similar to what we did this summer, where we have a volunteer comes in. It's called K-12. They come in with a kit that has learning materials in it, and they teach the first grade an hour long five times. So that's our K-12. And then we also have what we call Job Shadow, and that's where we actually have the student actually go out into the community, to organizations, to get a feel of what a real job's all about. And they tour through the facility during the day and so forth. So those are the three main programs that we offer. There's a couple one-off things that we do, like an ethics program, one called Capitalism with a Conscience, where we have business leaders from town walk into a high school 1 hour long and just literally talk to kids about what's ethical business and what they should strive to be and strive for as they become adults.
One of the things that we hear a lot about, a phrase that we hear in education, is 21st century skills, those kinds of skills that children are going to need for living in the real world, for what experiences they would have after high school, jobs, employment, that kind of thing. If you had to talk about the skills that you see children gaining from Junior Achievement that are going to help them in the world after they graduate, what kinds of skills do you see Junior Achievement developing within children?
Well, I'll tell you, I think it complements what's being taught in the classroom. A lot of it is taking the curriculum that our teachers are delivering to our kids and helping them gain the experience through seeing it through someone who's got the job, who's working out in the community. So that's one of the skills, are getting to get it from someone else other than just the teacher telling them at the end of the day. We know how strong and powerful that is, but every now and then it takes somebody other than dad or mom to tell them why to do something. It's nice to have somebody who actually has achieved that. So that skill. The other skill that we see is soft skills. I can't believe how important those skills are to these kids as they get older, and those are the simple things of understanding how to interview and shake someone's hand and look an individual in the eye and how to communicate and those types of things. That and lastly, this whole attitude shift, where I see kids every day learning that they truly can be and truly can do what they want to do in life. Those are what come out of the JA programs and experiences that we present.
Let me ask you this, Trent. What's your vision for Junior Achievement in Middle Tennessee?
Dr. Gilbert, you and I have talked a little bit about this. I actually support 18 different counties. I'm kind of that pie in the sky kind of guy. My vision is to make sure every child has the opportunity to succeed. That's my vision. So my goal is to try to find ways to engage the community, get involved in the classroom. And what we've seen, this goes way back, JA's been around since 1919, but what we've seen is when you can get mentors to go in the classroom and work with kids, kids are successful. They believe in themselves, they believe in their community, and they get back to their community. That's my goal. That's my pie-in-the-sky dream.
Okay, thank you. Leslie, let me ask you this. You get the last question.
Great.
What's your vision for Murfreesboro City Schools?
I just want to see every child be able to succeed. It's a challenging world, and I think if whatever we can do to help these kids along and help the parents and bring the families together and be able to just help them all succeed, I think at that point we've done our job.
Well, I want to thank you both for your pie in the sky and your vision, because we share that vision. We certainly are about children, and we're certainly about the academic and personal success of each child. Thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate your support of your children, and we appreciate your support of Murfreesboro City Schools. Have a great day.